Hi everyone, I'm Furkan. I'm developing a football game with my game engine. In this video, I'll show you the development stages I've been working on to implement the goalkeeper mechanics that involves orientation, locked movement, swinging arms, free jumping, and finally, saving the ball with diving. Goalkeeper is the second distinct player in the field after the dribbler. It plays a crucial role for the gameplay loop since it's responsible for stopping dribblers scoring goals. So it needed to be implemented to achieve a complete football simulation. Let's break down the steps I took to create the goalkeeper. I started with improving the orientation locked movement. This is the main movement type for a goalkeeper. During the game, the goalkeeper faces the ball or possible threads while moving freely without losing contact. Then I implemented a new stepping style that supports the short and precise steps. This made the short movement easy. I also spread the arms to the sides of the body to increase the cover area, and it already started to look like a real goalkeeper. I started to develop ball-saving mechanics by defining the contact area for touching the ball. The total contact area is constructed by 15 blocks. I simply divided the height by 3 and also created 3 different sections horizontally. The center one for blocking the ball with both hands, and the blocks on the side for pushing the ball with a single hand. I call these close area actions because the goalkeeper doesn't need to make a jump to reach the ball. Then I created a debug ball trajectory and implemented the intersection with the oriented bounding boxes of the save blocks. This is the starting point of deciding which save type is going to be performed. I created an algorithm to find the body pose for the save based on the ball intersection point. For this problem, I looked into some alternative inverse kinematic solutions, but I ended up using the existing character skeleton mechanics, which do the trick. Then I implemented a mechanic that enabled the character reaching the save pose. This involves applying the forces to the joints of the body through the target direction, constrained by the ball travel duration to the intersection point. After that, I involved the body momentum in the calculations to find the correct body pose while the player is moving around. This made the simulation even better, since it brings a whole lot of movement and action in. I started to test the system with a real ball, and I was literally shocked when I saw the result. It looked very satisfying to me how the whole action is performed. I iteratively modified the saving action for parry, which means pushing the ball to the sides. I also added punching the ball to the forward or upward with both hands. At this point, adding different save types like blocking the ball with a leg is going to be easy as the game is developed further. Then I returned to the core character system to refine the jumping mechanics. This was crucial for jump-assisted goalkeeper saves. I added a jump description that defines which way the jump will be performed, the body lean distance toward the jump direction, the durations for loading up and releasing the jump force, and also how much force is applied for each action. Then I combined the previous save pose calculations with the jump mechanics. This involved predicting and finding the correct parameters to perform the jump to reach the target save pose. First, I tried to create a machine learning solution, but I ended up using optimization algorithms, which helped as for now. Since the pipeline is almost ready, I'll train a machine learning model to increase the performance and accuracy further in the development. Then I implemented the rest of the integration, and the result was a jumping goalkeeper punching the ball in the air. I was relieved with the outcome because I wasn't sure how much effort it would take to achieve the jumping saves. The diving movement still lacks the completeness, since the player can't lay on the ground and get up. Like any ongoing project, there's always more to do, and that can lead to constant stress. In my search for ways to enhance productivity and overcome these challenges, I discovered some excellent classes on today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is the largest online learning community for creatives, with thousands of classes led by industry experts. With learning paths, curated, sequential class collections, you can dive deep and master specific skills, taking your career or hobbies to the next level. Skillshare offers a wide range of creative classes, from digital art and illustration to graphic design, animation, film, and productivity. For example, Productivity Masterclass from Ali Abdal teaches you how to design a customized productivity system to improve your efficiency and achieve your goals. The first 500 people to use my link in the description will receive a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Get started today. After combining the goalkeeper with the dribbler, I finally reached the gameplay that I imagined when I started this project. It's a big milestone since the foundation of the core features are now complete. There are still a lot of things to do, but as now the foundation is complete, the remaining gaps will be more straightforward to fill. I still haven't decided the final shape of the game when it's going to be released. the next goal is to create a satisfying gameplay loop that includes a single dribbler and a goalkeeper by completing the missing pieces that I will notice as I play. That comes to a public feedback channel that still doesn't exist. I kind of promised that I will share an open alpha, but this still remains uncertain because of the unpredictable timeline of the project development. The next update you'll see will be more robust and complete gameplay footage, and I hope for a possible release timeline. I want to thank everyone who has been part of this journey. Your support has meant a lot. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.